see, I can tell if the baby is took the first breath, or was the recent loss of float, this is full of air, if it sinks, maybe he's born still born. Alright, so now going on to stuff that's a little bit more difficult. It's going to take a lot of studying. What we're going to do is change of respiratory gases. So I'm going to start by giving you some Boyles. Remember Boyles' law? We did that already. Boyles' law was that the pressure of a gas is inversely proportional to the volume. This is what a kid knows. The kid knows if you take a balloon and you fill it with air, and you start to squeeze the balloon, making the volume what? Smaller? That number of what? The pressure goes up, and he knows the balloon will pop. Okay? There's love to do that. That's more than four. Then we have, easy one, Charles Boyle. Charles Boyle says simply that the volume of a gas, the volume, is proportional to the temperature of the gas. If I take a balloon and I fill it with gas, okay, not a lot, I'm not going to fill it with too much with gas, and maybe I'll fill it with enough gas that the balloon is not quite filled. I'll do that experiment. I'll take a balloon and I'll fill it with, get rid of that. Something that we don't really spend a lot of time on. If I raise the temperature even more, the what? The gas will expand even more and we'll have a larger volume. So I don't care about Charles. We don't really use that much. The one that we're going to spend a lot of time on is Dalton's law. Says that if you have a mixture of gases, of different gases, in a space, within a space, the total pressure saying the same thing again. Therefore, each gas exerts its own partial pressure. make it easy. You ready? Let's suppose you fill your lungs with air, okay? And the air in your lungs is 760 milliliters mercury. That's the total air in your lungs. What is that equal to? It's equal to the partial pressure of nitrogen plus the partial pressure of oxygen plus the partial pressure of CO2, and et cetera. You know, you have other gases, but they're not going to have a big pressure. So the total pressure is equal to what? The sum of the pressure of each individual gas, which is called the partial pressure. How do you calculate the partial pressure? It's really easy. You ready? What is the partial pressure of oxygen? Well, you have to know something. Oxygen is 21% of air. So, and what's its partial pressure? If the total pressure is 760, and 21% of it is what? Due to oxygen? Then you take 760 multiplied by 21%. Which will come to 159.60 millimeters of mercury. Everyone see how I did that? Folks? So the PO2 in air would be what? 159.6 millimeters mercury. That's the pressure it's exerting in your lung. The pressure due to oxygen. Then you want to know what's the percentage of CO2 in your lung. CO2, there's very little in this air. Really, really a little. What percent is CO2? Let me give you the exact number. 0.04%. That's it. 0.04% of the air in this room is carbon dioxide. So you take 760 and you multiply it by 0.04. You're going to do it. What do you get? How many millimeters?